Hi, I'm Dan Dockerty, star of the film Ashes to Ashes, here with the director of Ashes to Ashes, Dan Frantz, and we're here to talk about why the film failed. So, why do you think Ashes to Ashes failed?
I think it mainly failed. Let's explain what Ashes to Ashes is. It's a feature-length film that I wrote, starting back last winter, I guess? Yeah, last December almost, I think. That might be pushing. I don't know. I wrote it a long time ago. April, May. I don't know. Basically, it was a 12-page typed up script, and I had about like 40 pages that were handwritten, and this is all the script ever was. This is the only typed up version, and then I don't know where the other one is. I handwrote like 40 pages.
None of the actors had any scripts
either. And the film fell apart. It failed for numerous reasons. What we're gonna show you is the 15 minutes that survived and made it. So why do you think the film failed?
I think the film failed because we had a lack of a sense of direction where we were going with this. Actors didn't know what we were leading up to. None of us even really knew how the film was going to end. I didn't know about the ending until maybe day 4 of shooting, all the way back in spring. And
Tim, you can't talk. I apologize for the audio. We're using the Canon T2i stock mic, which sucks. So anything like a whisper from someone sitting right next to the camera is gonna get picked up. So this will probably be cut. So I don't know. Continue what we're talking.
And it's very hard as a professional actor to try and act without a sense of direction. And I think it affected the entire acting core with this video, so that was one of the issues.
Yeah, I think the main issue is no one had scripts. I didn't give anyone scripts. I didn't tell them what the story was. I was trying to do like retro scripting, which is basically I give them the general gist of the scene. No one really knows what the scene's actually about, and then they come up with the lines on their own, which sucked. So basically, if you're writing a feature-length film, number one thing, type up your entire script. Don't have half of it written in your chicken scratch handwriting that no one else can read. Number two, give the scripts to your actors. That's always important.
Yes.
Anyways, to give a brief outline of the story, so when you watch this 15 minutes, you know what it's about. Basically, it's set in a post-apocalyptic wasteland where, do you even know what your character is?
My character's name was Seth, and he wakes up in the middle of nowhere after being demolished by some unknown force that we don't even get to find out who they are in the 15 minutes we shot. But he's trying to get his bearings again and trying to remember where he's going, who he is, and what he's doing in this post-apocalyptic world. And you see his process of trying to get up after being beaten down by these assailants.
That's about all the film is him standing up. That's and walking around. Anyways, basically to give you a super brief outline, he gets beat by bad people. He has no recollection of what happened to him. He slowly realizes that he was in charge of the bad guys, and these bad guys were called the Voice, which I'll play the clip like right now. You'll see the evil of the Voice.
Anger's a gift!
essentially was the leader of the voice, and then one of his like right-hand man betrayed him and viciously beat him, and they thought they killed him, but he just died, and he didn't die. He was viciously beaten to the point where he had severe amnesia and trauma.
So was Matt Coon my right-hand man?
No, yeah, he was.
See,
I'm finding out about the story right now.
Didn't even know that.
Basically, to give you a brief overview of who the bad guys were, they were called the Voice. They had separate encampments all over the U.S., and they were just kind of like this psycho-anarcho-crazy cult.
Anarcho.
Yeah, and the leader of the Voice, who played, he was called the Speaker of the Voice, and that's about all we filmed of them. Oh, and you'll see that these guys wandering around, they have, it sounds like there's flood noises from Halo, because there is flood noises from Halo, and the idea was that these guys didn't have mouths. I'll put a little image here of Keanu Reeves, because there's some scene in The Matrix where he doesn't have a mouth, and they were all supposed to look like that. I was going to do that like with latex. There's going to be a big unmasking scene, and you're like, oh, these guys don't have mouths.
I never really understood why they didn't have mouths.
And they bleed black blood.
Well, that's kind of cool. That's kind of like, oh, maybe they're mutated. But like,
there was no...
Do you mutate and lose a mouth?
As you can see, this is why this film failed. There was no explanation of anything. Other thing was dialogue. Any dialogue I shot sucked.
When you put it that way, it doesn't sound so appealing.
Well, neither does getting beat to death.
Guess I don't have much of a choice, do I?
2, 3.
Kill the radio. 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 Kill the radio.
It was mainly me and him. Another thing, I didn't have control of any of the actors that were there. Especially that big scene that we shot.
Act like I want you to be... Somebody walk out in the open with the M4!
Yeah. We got to the first battle sequence, and we had like 15 kids just mulling around with guns and camo on.
And then they all ended up leaving for whatever reason. We were left to three of us, perhaps, and you can't film a battle with three people.
Yeah, it sucked. I didn't plan that out at all. And we put up a whole bunch of guns on you.
Yeah.
I'll put that video right now.
We do have a picture of that.
I'll put the video.
Words to the camera. It's rolling right now, I got it.
I guess my last words would be... Watch what we have and decide for yourselves whether you think it was a failed project or not. But we canceled it.
The battery died, that's why it cut out, and I wanted to say that half of it is not color corrected, so half of it looks really good, half of it looks bad. So here's the movie.
just want some soup.
What are you thinking? 300 yards or four?
I'd go four, but aim a little high. Shit, give me that. I'm all out of jerky.
On the one, the only Tony Fox bringing your buffet of tunes to your ears every hour on the hour. For those of you out there who have managed to scrap together a radio, you are listening to The Ways of Phoenix 104.5 FM, broadcasting live from the Last Hope Complex. Now in these next few hours, we are going to have a real treat for you folks out there. My good friend Vincent here, who has just made it to the Last Hope Complex all the way from the fine state of Ohio, has just brought in some 10-inch records. We're talking the good stuff. You know, some Sinatra, some Holiday, some Crosby. But for now, we'll start you out with some Bobby Darin. Here's Beyond the Sea.
Let me give you a hand.
Thanks.
I'm surprised your skull's not cracked. So what the hell happened?
I'm not really sure. Last thing I remember, I was facing out on a lake not too far from here. Felt like someone had pump battery acid through my veins.
Someone definitely wants you dead. There's no denying that.
That's reassuring. I don't think I call your name.
Claire.
I'm Seth.
Also, I'm not sure if you heard the radio, but that DJ, Tony Fox, has his own little oasis among the shithole. That's where I'm headed, and have been headed for the last year. In the next couple of minutes, I'm gonna walk out that door and be on my way. Well, the way I see it, you have two options. One, stay here and fend for yourself. Or two, stick with me. Judging how option one worked for you last time, I'd go with option two.
Well, then I'll stick with you.
Ah, therein lies the problem. You see, I'm not too partial to company. If in fact you do decide to come with me, when I say jump, you sure as hell better jump. When I say fire, you ask at who. And above all else, stay out of my way.
When you put it that way, it doesn't sound so appealing.
Well, neither does getting beat to death.
Guess I don't have much of a choice, do I?
The way I see it, if we cut up through this valley here, we shouldn't have a problem from there on out. If we cut through the valley, that might be pushing it. We'll be less than a stone's throw away from the border.
Exactly. That way, we don't have to deal with a voice, if we lay low.
Alright. Looks like a pretty straight shot.
That it does. We'll be right back.